is ESPN on ABC.
Possible.
Don't go out there and have fun. Ball out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The opportunity you have, man, respect it. Be in the moment and communicate. I'm
down the drain. Tennessee's off to the races.
Coming to say, Mar, say, to keep our foot on their throat.
Charlotte, North Carolina. A spectacular night for football. The temperature is just perfect for a rare showdown between two teams not separated by too much distance, but a lot of history between the two, just not when they clash. Tennessee and North Carolina State, welcome to the Duke's Mayo Classic. This is Saturday Night Football presented by Capital One. You'd think these two would have run across each other a little more often. It hasn't happened a lot. Glad to have you with us. Reese Davis, Kirk Herbstreit, Chris Fowler's covering the U.S. Open. He will be back next week. These two teams are going to try to prove something, and if we've learned anything today so far, it's that you just don't know this early in the season.
Man, gosh. You know, we just saw Notre Dame last week against Texas A&M, and Kyle Field thought, boy, they found a way to win. Now they're going to really take off, and we're just all reminded once again, you never assume anything in college football. Northern Illinois showed up. Notre Dame maybe looking past Northern Illinois, and they take an L, first one of the year.
You know what? The fans clad in big orange here in Charlotte tonight, they have a major reason to believe and a lot of optimism, and his name is Nico Iamaleava, one of the highest-touted prospects at quarterback, dominated 7-on-7 in pajama pants, made a first start in the bowl game last year, won that. And them do a bowl win, first guy since Peyton Manning to do that as a freshman. And in the Smoky Grays against Chattanooga, he was spinning the beam, went for three bills last
night. Well, Iamaleava is a quarterback that came with huge credentials out of high school, as you just documented. And I think the anticipation's been great. We saw him in the Iowa bowl game last year, last week against UT Chattanooga. But I feel like this stage and this opponent really is going to give us an opportunity to see what he's all about. Josh Heupel has a very complicated offense, the way they attack downfield. They challenge the defenses, and here comes Dave Doran, a very chip on his shoulder kind of head coach, defensive-minded head coach, welcoming the opportunity to try to prove people wrong today.
A little bit of a different style of defense that Iamaleava will see, maybe for the first time in his career. But Grayson McCall of North Carolina State, he's seen just about everything. Played high school ball not far from where we are, Indian Trail, about 21 miles from Charlotte. Not highly recruited, went to Coastal Carolina, started 40 times, threw for 10,000 yards, and won Sun Belt Player of the Year three times. And last December, transferred here, and they think that he might be the guy to get them over the hump. 10 wins, conference championship contention.
Don't take that lightly. Three-time conference player of the year, 41 career starts. We've really been marveling about his skill set over the last few years, and now he gets into the big boys conferences with North Carolina State, and he's going up against Tennessee. I think you're going to see contrasting styles. North Carolina State, they want to pound the football. Maybe some extra linemen, try to wear Tennessee down defensively, and also keep Nico on the sideline with all that ability.
It has been a wild day in the sport. We will document some of it coming up in a matter of moments and closing in on kickoff between the Big Orange and the Wolfpack here on Saturday Night Football.
The Nissan pregame drive is next after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
This is Nico, number 8, and already anointed as the quarterback who will lead Tennessee back to the college football mountaintop.
Touchdown for Iamaleava. It's turning into a coming out party.
Iamaleava's certainly not the first teenage quarterback to feel the weight of Rocky Top on his shoulders.
Manning going big.
But this is Tennessee. We don't hide from leadership. We volunteer.
That's another laser. There ain't no easy
way. The North Carolina State Wolfpack also knows big-time QBs. Now, Grayson McCall has arrived to try and follow in their cleat steps.
McCall shoots it in zone. Touchdown.
The promise of greatness is over. It's time to deliver.
Oh, I won't back down.
Special thanks to our good friend Peyton Manning doing that tease for us. Saturday night football here in Charlotte, Tennessee, North Carolina State. The Volunteers donning those stormtrooper look uniforms, a sweet all white look against the red. And there is the winningest coach in Pack history, Dave Doran, who's with Holly Rowe.
Coach Doran, your quarterback, has a lot of experience, but this will be his first time facing an SEC defense. How can he succeed tonight?
Grayson's a really good football player. It's about us. It's not about the opponent this whole game. We got to go out and execute, play with great fundamentals, and play as a football team.
Their tempo can be a challenge. How will your defense find a way to balance that out?
Well, you can't let them repetitively get first downs. You got to have success on first and second down to set up third downs that are manageable on our end and get off the field when we do that.
All right, you've got a special fan tonight that's giving you good luck, Leonie Vanderwoody. Tell me about her.
Yeah, 105 years old this week. We call her Moo. We love you, Moo. Happy birthday, 105 years.
That's your mother-in-law. I figure that's good mojo, Coach. Thank you.
That is a wise man right there. Always be kind to the mother-in-law.
Oh, yeah.
And happy birthday, 105 years old.
That's great.
Fantastic. Hope she enjoys the game tonight. Tennessee won the toss. They defer, so North Carolina State will go on offense first. The Wolfpack won their season opener against Western Carolina, a little tougher than anticipated. Volunteers come in after blowing out Chattanooga. So this really the first heavyweight on heavyweight test for these two teams. Volunteers lining up to kick it off. Their kickoff specialist is Josh Turbyville and Hollywood Smothers from here in Charlotte, one of the deep men back for North Carolina State. Just about set to go from Charlotte.